I run a medical nonprofit organization called Soft Power Health here in Chibera Village. And we have a primary and preventative healthcare clinic and three health education outreach programs and a very large organic garden. I came to Uganda in 2003 on a kayaking trip. And after one of the people I was with got malaria and I had to treat them, then I started asking questions about how the local people here dealt with malaria. And that led to a 50-home survey. And basically we found out that people didn't understand how they got malaria. They were interested in learning more about malaria and they were willing to purchase mosquito nets. So we started a malaria outreach. It's education and prevention of malaria with the sale of subsidized mosquito nets and follow-up visits, which we do to net purchasers' homes 6 months to 8 months after they've purchased the net. That's one in our longest standing outreach. The next one is family planning, which has been going for 8 years now. And the same model, we educate people about conception and contraception, and we provide short-term and intermediate terms of family planning in the field to women who are interested. So that's Injectaplan, injection of Depo-Provera, or birth control pills and condoms. And then we go back to the same villages to follow up with ladies to see how they're doing. And then finally, we have a malnutrition outreach, which is based on the same concept of education about nutrition and malnutrition and showing people what malnutrition looks like in their children and then how to correct it through nutritionally balanced meals with food that is readily available to them. In addition to that program has been helping people create gardens that will be successful gardens, i.e. they replace nitrogen in the soil, they use organic methods of gardening so they're not poisoning themselves with the pesticides they can buy in the market, and then they are actually eating foods that have nutritional value so that they and their families can be healthy. We have a large organic garden at the clinic, which serves as our demonstration garden for organic gardening techniques, so we can teach community members about how it works. Then we can also grow enough food to feed all of our staff their lunchtime meal. And then if we have surplus, then we sell that for income generation. We see 75 patients a day on average at the clinic, so over 20,000 patients a year. We have an entirely Ugandan staff except for one person who's from New Hampshire. So we have 50 Ugandans that work for us, and that includes doctors, nurses, laboratory technicians, gardeners, health educators, cooks, cleaners, you name it. If you can help just one person, and I mean really help them, you've made a huge difference.